Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, we are in the 16th Sunday of the Ordinary Time, and today the spiritual nourishment for us is from Jeremiah chapter 23 verses 1 to 6, the second reading Ephesians chapter 2 verses 13 to 18, and the Gospel of Mark chapter 6 from verses 30 to 34. In today's Gospel, Jesus commands us to take rest. He says, "Come away to a deserted place, all by yourselves, and rest a while." We are living in a world where money has more value than anything else. Therefore, nobody wants to waste their time, because wasting time means wasting money. And that's why we are busy doing so many things. There is no time for us to look back and reflect upon the past, because most of us think that reflecting upon the past means regretting about our life and wasting our time. But today Jesus tells us to take a rest. There are four elements in Jesus' instruction, and there is something to be discovered in each element. First, He says, "Come away." Second, to a deserted place. Third, by all yourselves. And the fourth, rest a while. Jesus says, "Come away." Here we have to understand that He does not say, "Go away." Rather, He says, "Come away," which means He wants us to come with Him. Because all this time, we are busy doing so many things, away from the Lord, with our own strength, with our own ability, with our own capacity. As a result, we are worried, tired, exhausted, loaded with so many things, not knowing what to do. But Jesus is calling us to come away, because that is where we are going to find our rest. Then He said, to a deserted place. Very often we go to a retreat center to renew ourselves, to recharge ourselves, thinking that we are away from the busy world, but living amidst thousands of people in the retreat house. But if you really want to renew yourselves, recharge yourselves, or want to have a good retreat, you should try retreats where you are totally on your own. The next thing that Jesus says, by yourselves. He says, that is you, all by yourselves. It is not the friends, companions, families, relatives who are going to take you, but you are going by yourselves. And finally, He says, rest a while. It is a temporary state, and once we renew or recharge ourselves, we need to get back to our work. We need to help others to renew themselves. We need to have compassion towards others as Jesus had compassion towards people. I would like to narrate a short story to understand the importance of helping others. A holy man once having a conversation with the Lord. One day he said, "Lord, I would like to know what heaven and hell are like." The Lord led the holy man to two doors. One he opened one of the doors and the holy man looked inside. In the middle of the room was a large round table. On the table was a large pot of stew, which smelled delicious. The people sitting around the table were thin and sickly. They appeared to be striving. They were holding spoons with very long handle that were strapped to their arms, and each found it impossible to reach into pot of stew and take a spoonful because the handle was larger than their arms. They could not get the spoon back into their mouth. The holy man was surprised at the sight of their miseries and suffering. The Lord said, you have seen the help. Then they went to the next room and opened the door. It was exactly the same as the first one. The people were equipped with the same thing, same long-handled spoons, but here the people were well-nourished, laughing, talking, enjoying their life. The holy man said, "I don't understand." The Lord said, "It is simple. You see, they have learned to feed each other, while the greedy one only think of themselves." So in this chaotic situation, in this pandemic situation, let us be aware of the needs of others. Let us be compassionate towards others, as Jesus was aware of the needs of his disciples as well as the needs of his people. May God bless us all.